StarGenetics video tutorial number 2, StarGenetics user interface. In this video, we will explore the StarGenetics user interface, including the strains and property boxes, active and saved experiment windows, and the Punnett square tool. When you first open a StarGenetics exercise, you will see the StarGenetics user interface. On the left side of the screen, we have the strains box. This box contains all of the organisms provided to you to use in this exercise. Below the strains box is the properties box. When you click on an individual organism, the properties box will give you details about this organism. If we click on mutant 1, the properties box will list the name and phenotype of the fly, which in this case includes the sex, body color, and wing size. To change the name of a fly, click on the name box in the properties box, and enter the new name of the organism, and click OK. You can also use this procedure to rename any of the progeny you generate during your experiments. The properties box also includes the number of matings in which this particular fly can participate. This number may be adjusted in different exercises, so make sure you don't exceed the maximum matings for each organism. In this example, each fly can participate in 100 matings, so you are unlikely to exceed this number of matings with a single parent. But in other exercises, or with certain organisms, the total number of matings may be limited, and you must carefully plan your experiment to not exceed this number. In the notes section, you can write notes or observations you have made as you complete crosses. For example, as you are determining which mutant phenotypes are dominant or recessive, you can write this in the notes box to keep track of this information. You can minimize the properties box and maximize the strains box by clicking the minimize icon in the top right corner of the properties box. The active experiment window includes the mating site, where you drag the flies you wish to cross, and also displays progeny from this cross in one of three tabs: the individual tab, the sorted tab, or the summary tab. We will talk more about these tabs, how to perform crosses, and how to analyze the results from these crosses in the next video. The saved experiments window will include the progeny from previous crosses you have saved. You can access particular experiments by selecting them from the drop-down menu here in the saved experiments window. One useful tool in StarGenetics for predicting ratios is the Punnett square tool, accessible by clicking Punnett square above the strains box. With this tool, you have the option of looking at the inheritance patterns of a trait encoded by a single autosomal gene, two unlinked autosomal genes, or a sex-linked gene. You select the genotype of each parent separately and see the expected genotypic frequency that would result in the progeny in that cross. By comparing this genotypic frequency with the phenotypic frequencies you see in the progeny from a cross, this can assist you in determining the genotypes of the parents, progeny, or how the trait in question is inherited. We will use this tool in the next video to help us determine how mutant traits are inherited. Once you have completed some crosses in StarGenetics, you can save your progress as a .sg1 file to open later in StarGenetics, and you can continue where you left off. To do this, go to File, Save, enter a name for your set of experiments, then click Save. You can also export your experiments as an Excel file by going to File, Save Report as Excel Workbook, entering a name for the file, and clicking Save.